Since seeing Dr. Now, I've been hitting my diet and exercise hard. I've started working out at a nearby gym, and it's the first time I've done anything like this. And normally, I wouldn't have even considered it because of my anxiety. But my mom found me a gym nearby that has a more private room to work out. And I've really started to enjoy that time. The first few times were really hard, but now I feel like I'm able to do more and I'm making progress. And when people come in, as long as it's not too many, I can handle it. Taking that trip to Houston helped me get a little more used to being in public because I didn't really have a choice then. And I got to see how much I could handle because I've always just avoided going out as much as possible. And if I had to, I made it quick. But I'm trying to work on that fear and anxiety of being out because I know I'm gonna have to do it more, especially for my next trip to Houston because my mom isn't gonna be able to make it. She's traveling for a few weeks, but I don't want to miss my appointment. So I plan to make the trip on my own, no matter what it takes. And if I get approved for weight loss surgery, my mom is even going to put her whole life on hold to move down to Houston with me. And I'm thankful and excited about that possibility.
When I run out of groceries at the house, there's only really one place I can go to get something that's decent. So I'm on my way there now to just get some grilled chicken.
How much can I get for you today?
Can I get 2 12 counts of the grilled nuggets, just the entree, and a large ice water?
Sure thing. Anything else?
Nope, that's it.
Here you go, sir.
Thanks, man. Have a good one.
It feels like I've revamped my whole life from the ground up. And instead of just eating all day, I'm sticking to eating only 3 times a day with food that's on Dr. Now's diet plan. So that's a huge change for me.
Hey, Finn. Hey, buddy.
I just have to keep working hard and make sure I hit my goal before I see Dr. Now again. I have a little over a month before that, and I don't plan to let up even for a moment until then. I'm sticking to the diet and pushing myself to work as hard as I can. So that when I go back down and step on that scale, I know that no matter what that number is, I did everything I could to get where I need. I just really hope it's enough. I'm currently back in Houston and on my way to see Dr. Now for my follow-up appointment. And I'm really nervous because a lot is riding on today. The past 2 months have been really hard. But knowing how important this is, I've worked as hard as I could to stick with it. And I know I've made progress because of how much easier it is to get around. I just need it to be enough.
Justin McSwain?
When I was here last, I was up to 687. And Dr. Now told me I had to lose at least 100 pounds over the past 2 months. That means if I hit my goal, I'll be down to 587 today, which I'm really hoping I did.
595.
All right.
That's amazing. I know I'm not quite to the goal Dr. Now gave me, but this is a lot of weight loss, and I'm hoping it shows Dr. Now I'm ready for surgery and he approves me today.
Hey, Justin, how are you?
Pretty good. How are you?
I'm great, especially seeing your weight loss. You lost 92 pounds in 2 months, not quite 100, but that's close enough. So I'm approving you for weight loss surgery, okay?
All right. Awesome.
But before we move ahead, you need to move down here to Houston. So, you ready for that?
Okay, yeah.
Great, so as soon as you're fully down here, let me know, we'll get you on schedule, as long as you continue to lose and stay on track, okay?
Okay.
But if you don't, we won't be able to do weight loss surgery, and we will need to start this process again. Got it?
Yes, sir.
But right now, you're doing great. I'm very proud of Justin and the progress he has made. But ultimately, to be successful in the long term, Justin is gonna need to work through a lot of his emotional issues. But right now, the next step for him will be to get weight loss surgery. All right, keep losing like you are and stay on track. And I'll wait for you to get down to Houston and we'll see you then, okay?
Thank you, sir.
All right.
Me and my dad are at Dr. Now's for my next appointment. I feel like I've made some progress. I just hope it's enough.
Justin?
At my last weigh-in 2 months ago, I was down to 446. And Dr. Now said I should be losing at least 20 pounds a month at this point. So if I'm back on track, that'll mean I'll at least be below 406 today. That's a good one.
Dude, that's killing it, man.
Yeah, that's a really good one.
You're just killing it.
Yeah. It's a lot lower than what it's been, like, in
that's
a long
insane.
Time.
That's crazy.
Such a long time. Thank you.
Sorry.
I'm really excited right now because I'm more than back on track. And to see a 3 come up before my weight is amazing. So I hope Dr. Now is happy with where I'm at, because I am, and I feel really good right now.
Hello.
Hey.
How y'all doing?
Good. How are you, Doctor?
So, Justin, you are down to 395 today.
Yes, sir.
And you have lost 292 pounds from day one I saw you.
Yeah.
So that's almost loss of 200 pounds in a year. That's excellent. You're doing great. How you feel losing all that weight?
Incredible. It just makes it all worth it.
Well, I'm proud of you. And at this rate, you're going to need extra skin removal soon. So once you get under 300 here soon, we will consider you for that.
All right. That sounds awesome. Thank you.
All right. I'm proud of your progress. And
thank you.
I will see you soon.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you again, sir.
All right. Take care.
Let's go lose some more weight.
Yeah. I am very proud of Justin and all the progress he has made over the past year. He's done great, and he's been one of the most determined and hardworking weight loss patients I have ever had. And as long as he continues going to therapy and working through his emotional issues, I'm very confident he's gonna make it to his target weight soon, and then be able to do this for the long term.